Today is also auspicious day in sequence, in the line as other days we observed. So, the appearance day of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, disappearance day of Namacharya Haridas Thakur, and Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, and today's Vishwarup Prabhu Mahotsav, the sannyas day of Param Gurudev, Shri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, and sannyas day of Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj Ji. Here, in our time, according India is tomorrow. So, in that sequence, in the series of so many auspicious days, today is also Purnima here, and also a very auspicious day. So, I want to sing this bhajan because a narration of Mahaprabhu, being only because of one point here, I chose this bhajan. Mundita Mundam, Mahaprabhu shaved, took sannyas. This Purnima. So we can sing together. So when I'm going to sing the first line, you can follow that same melody. O Jwalavarana Gauravara Deham Vilasitane Ravadi Bhava Videham Tribhuvana Pavanam Kripayalesham Tam pranamami cha Shri Sachitanaya Gada Gadayantara Bhava Vikara Durjanata Jana Nada Vishala Bhava Bhaya Bhanjana Karana Karuna Tam Pranamami Cha Shri Sachitanaya Aruna Varadhara Charu Kapola Indu Vinindita Nakachaya Ruchira Jalapita Nija Guna Nama Vinoda Tam Pranamami Cha Shri Sachitanayam Vigalita Nayanaka Malajaladharam Bhushananavarasa Bhavavikaram Gatiyatimanthara Nrityavilasam Tam Pranamami Cha Shri Sachitanayam Chanchala Charucha Ranagati Ruchiram Manjira Ranjita Padayuga Madhuram Chandra Vinindita Shitalavadana Tam Pranamami Cha Shri Sachitanaya Dritakati Doraka Mandaludandam Divya Kalevara Mundita Mundam आनंदम दुर्जनकर्मशा खंडनग्रन्दम तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनय भूषण भूरज अलकावलीत कंपितबिम्बं धरवररुचिर मलयज विरचिता उज्ज्वलतिलक तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनयम् निन्दितयरुणक मलदलनयनम् आजानुलाम्भिता श्रीभुजयुगलम् कलेवरकेश्वरा नर्तकवेश तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनयम् तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनयम् तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनयम् तं प्रणमामि च श्रीसचितनयम् सचिनन्दन जय गौर हरि सचिनन्दन जय गौर हरि जय नदिया बिहारी जय गौर हरि संकीर्तन बिहारी जय गौर हरि जय नित्यानंद प्राण धन गौर हरि अद्वैतेर प्राण धन गौर हरि जय गदाधर प्राण धन गौर हरि भक्तवृंद प्राण धन गौर हरि गौरा हे गौरा हे गौरा हे गौरा हे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नित्य गौर हरि भो हरि भो हरि भो हरि भो नित्य गौर हरि भो हरि भो हरि भो हरि भो नित्य गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि भो हरे कृष्णा ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाये प्रियात्मने श्री श्रीमान् भक्ति वेदांत नारायण इति नामने नमो विष्णु पादाय आचार्य सिंह रूपने श्रीमान भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी इति नामिने नमो विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमान भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद बोलो हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे Okay, so there is a good news. In material world, they always we hear some good news and bad news. Yeah. Good news always makes us happy, and bad news makes us sad. But with a proper understanding of the philosophy and with the maturity and seeing how Srila Gurudev, all of our acharyas, what they understood to be good or bad news, they're not comparing any material kind of good or bad news related to spiritual world. In spiritual world, there is always a good news. Everything is good. Sometimes a person may feel, oh, that's very bad for me. But who knows what is the plan of Krishna? Maybe that bad news is the cause of the next step, which is upcoming good news. Who knows that? Therefore, there is no need to interfere in Krishna's activities and his desires, which is the desires which is falling upon us, or he wants to impose on us. Anyway, just an introduction. Many devotees, we heard yesterday when it was on Zoom, London, Yashoda Didi, and there was Yashoda Nandan Prabhu was hosting Harikatha, the meeting. And everyone was glorifying Sri Srimad Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj for his great contribution to this world. And even we had also program yesterday here, and devotees were glorifying him. Very good point came up. Just like Srila Gurudev, Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, he highlighted to the whole world Radha Dasyam. The aim and object of Gaudiya Vaishnavas is to attain the lotus feet of Radha Rani. So it's just the matter of speciality of acharyas. Right? It's not that Gurudev did not glorify other acharyas. He did. But his speciality, his focus, and in his preaching, in his words, every time, it's always coming up with the word Radha Dasyam. Similarly, in regard to Sri Srimad Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, his speciality was Vaishnav Seva. Very wonderfully said yesterday by one devotee. Vaishnav Seva. What he have observed, seeing in all his authorities, means his masters, or in other words, the way he used to address them as my beloved masters. He used to address them. The service mood of all the acharyas, Param Gurudev, Srila Swami Maharaji, Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, and all other acharyas, my Guru Maharaj. So Srila Maharaj adopted that mood and he applied in his life. And since beginning, even to the last stage, in his advanced age, he followed this the system of Vaishnav Seva. Earlier, when he was physically strong, he did Vaishnav Seva. And in his advanced age, with his speech, with his Harikatha, he did Vaishnava Seva. Whoever used to come to him, any time, morning, noon, evening, is always ready to answer those questions and encourage devotees. This is Vaishnava Seva. Speaking Harikatha is also Vaishnava Seva. I really liked and impressed by hearing this. So Vaishnava Seva, that was the point where Srila Maharaj was always focusing on and inspiring others to do that. So, being inspired by that, what was there in his heart and his experiences and realizations by being with his beloved masters, he presented that heart in the form of this book, My Beloved Masters, with a very special mercy of our Srila Gurudev, my Guru Maharaj, all Acharyas, and of course, with a very, very compassionate, merciful glance of him to the fallen soul like myself, I got inspired to make this book as audio book so that devotees can hear while at work, at home, or at office, or while driving. So much inspiring and inspirational words, the dealings of Vaishnavas. And their high idols, everything is mentioned in that. When we hear that, we can understand, oh, our acharyas, how high standard they had and what they're expecting from us as well. So it's not only me who worked on this book. I want to acknowledge and very, very special thanks to the whole teamwork. Who work day and night to make this work very successful. I want to give special thanks to them from all of us, because it's easy to read a book, to buy a book, to purchase a book, or to hear the book. But those who make this book, they know how much hardship is there. Struggling moments are there. So I don't want to take any credit for this. Of course, all credit goes to Sri Sriman Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj to present this to this world, this great work. Otherwise, we would have bereft of even knowing the names of those acharyas. We don't even know them, right? But when you read this, when you hear this, then you come to know the names, and then you understand the glories. And then from the heart, the desire comes to pray to them. Can we also follow the same standard as you did under the guidance of your Guru Vargas? Definitely this desire comes, and a heart melts to hear that. So, first of all, I'd like to pay my obeisances and very special thanks to the team who made this book, My Beloved Master. And first of all, Shripad Madhapriya Prabhu, who made notes when Srila Bharati Maharaji was speaking. He was not speaking a lectures on this, so it was not that easy to hear those lectures and write down this. No, it was just some private darshans in the room or some occasions he's speaking. And Shripad Madhapriya Prabhu always making notes and compiled this to my understanding. And then Sundar Gopal Prabhu from Australia, his brother Achintya Gopal Prabhu, and there are many, Amrish Prabhu, Lavanga Didi, many other devotees. who worked on that book. But on this audio book, which I tried to do my best according to my broken English and not to the up-to-standard English as UK or US English, it's like an Indian English. But I understand devotees who know the subject matter. They're very open-minded and generous. And I expect they will accept the mood, not just the vocabulary. As said in Srimad Bhagavatam, couple of times when I did Bhagavad Sapta in English as well as in Hindi, the words spoken by Naraji to Vedvyasi, Tadvag Sargo Jamto Viployasmi Pratishlokam Badatamapi Yasho Inkintani Yashanvanti Gayanti Garananti Sadhava. The nature of saintly person is they don't give importance to the ornamental language. This is a verse, first canto Bhagavatam. Even if any composition, any poetry which is not nicely made or nicely announced or pronounced, but every word, every shloka is there, every page is there in the glorification of Krishna, the Lord Krishna, then the nature of sadhu is to hear, to speak, and to remember. And it's so pleasing for the sadhus, saintly person. So I expect all sadhus, devotees, Vaishnava or Vaishnavis, when you're going to hear this, you might come across some mistakes in pronunciation or other things. But I think we can all grasp the mood which is present there. So those who worked on this, I first of all like to say thanks to Yashodari Didi. She worked so much day and night. She didn't sleep for almost 30 hours to complete this, to release this book on this special auspicious day. The discipline is of Sri Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj, which is happening in India today. So can we all just clap for her? I don't know if she's here on the screen, but later devotees can say thanks to her for this. And then some boys, Naveen Krishna Prabhu, Nitai Prabhu, Vasudev Prabhu, also, they worked so hard, very hard actually, from so many weeks on this. So immediately after this class, they're going to release on Harikatha group. You all get this book today. And we are right from my heart. I sincerely apologize and beg forgiveness for troubling them so much. And also at the same time, I want to say thanks to them to work on this book for the benefit of the masses. The whole world will get benefited by this. We all pray for their, to our Gurudev, to our Guru Parampara, for their spiritual life. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Thank you. So that was an announcement. Today's Vishwarup Mahotsav. Who is Vishwarup Prabhu? Vishwarup Prabhu, elder brother of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This little account of Sri Vishwar Prabhu mentioned in Sri Chaitanya Chaitamrita and Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat. When the elder brother of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when Mahaprabhu was small young boy staying in Mayapur, with his mother Sachi Mata and father Sri Jagannath Mishra. Sri Jagannath Mishra, he left this world. And then Sachi Mata was with two boys. Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu came to know about appearance of Mahaprabhu. So he made his residence very near to Yogpit, the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. So he came from Shantipur to Mayapur. And Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu was reciting Srimad Bhagavatam every day, Hari Katha every day. Vishwarup Prabhu, by his nature, he always wants to hear the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. So he was attending the classes by Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu. Don't move the screen. Be still. If you're moving, then please switch off your camera. Samajhe baat ko? Don't move here and there. Just be frozen and still. Freeze yourself. If you're moving, then I'm speaking to them in India. If you're moving, then switch off your camera. But in Hari Katha, just think, Mataji, just think that you are sitting right in class and I'm sitting in front. And you know my style. When anyone moves, I get a little disturbed. So, yes, thank you. What I was saying. Vishwa Prabhu, by nature, he was very fond of hearing Srimad Bhagavat Katha. He was going every day to hear Bhagavat Katha from Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu. Sometimes he gets so much absorbed in hearing and Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu in speaking that where the time passed, they were not even aware of that. And so sometimes when he's late coming back home, Sachi Mata used to tell Nimai, Mahaprabhu, Nimai, go and call your Dada. Dada here means elder brother. Go and call your elder brother. It's too late. He has to eat. Sachi Mata, full of affection. So Nimai Pandit means young boy. Only wearing one small garment and looks so beautiful and looks so, so effulgent. He's going there and with soft words, like a child, he used to say to Vishwa Prabhu, his elder brother, come, come, Sachi Mata calling you. I is calling you. I means Mata. So, not that English I. But in Hindi, especially in Bengal, they address mother as I. So, I is calling you, means mother is calling you. And seeing this young boy and hearing his captivating words, Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu, he got so much attracted. And later he used to wonder, who is this boy? Who attracts me so much? His words, his appearance is attracting me, captivating me. What is special about this boy? It cannot be any ordinary material attraction. There is something. This voice pulling my attention. What is that? So Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu used to wonder, what is that? So then Vishwarup Prabhu and Nimai, both hands in hands, they come back to home and Sachi Mata used to give them prasadam. Hearing so much Bhagavatam and of course from Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu, because yesterday in the Hari Katha, we also came to know who was Gurudev of Sri Haridas Thakur, from whom he got Harinam Diksha. So we heard in Hari Katha, he got Harinam from Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu. So Sri Advaitacharya Prabhu, very near and dear to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So his Harikatha is full of all renunciation. Bhagavatam itself is Parahansa Sahita. Means there is no other dharma involved in that. Not dharma, earth, kam and moksha. Dharma projit kaitav atro parmo nirmasaranam satam. Vedyam vastam atravastu shivadam tapatrayana mulmam. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there is only one subject mentioned there. What is that? Krishna Prem and renunciation. There is no bhogava, there is nothing for sense gratification narrated in Srimad Bhagavatam. And of course, when a great Vaishnav like Sri Advaita Acharya Prabhu is speaking this, so Vishwaroop Prabhu, he felt renunciation. He felt this sansar, this world is asar. Asar means the sar, the essence of this world is only bhajan of Krishna. That's all. And everything else is all material relationship. Even though he's staying with his eternal mother, Sachi Mata, but Vishwaroop Prabhu decided to take sannyas, want to renounce. So he left home, took sannyas. And he went to all the places of pilgrimage in India. Finally, his last pastime, he went to the very important place called Pandharpur in Maharashtra. That's the middle of India. Pandharpur, Maharashtra, which is in the state Maharashtra. There is very prominent, very important deity of Bhagwan called Vitthal Nath. Indian devotees, they know this. Vitthal Nath, who's standing like this on a brick. He's standing like this on the brick. It's called Vitthal Nath. And his very favorite, his devotee was Tukaram, who always used to sing and chant the glories of Vitthal Nath. Panduranga, Panduranga, all that day and night he's chanting Panduranga, Panduranga, Panduranga. Even though he was householder, staying with his wife, his children, but he was not affected by this duties of householders. But he was always and always chanting, not even working, but day and night just chanting the glories. He used to compose songs and sitting in isolation, chanting Panduranga, Panduranga, and so many bhajans in his language, Marathi, Maharashtra language. Many people became envious to him. And long story. Once upon a time, his wife was so much against him because he was not giving attention to the family. So she's always like chastising him, fighting with him. Will your Panduranga will feed us? Will your Vitthal Nath feed us? You're not working all the time, which is singing and chanting this name. And he's not giving any attention. He's just quiet and Panduranga, Panduranga. He has this belief that, oh, he's the maintainer of the universe. He's Vishwambhar. Yeah. So why have to worry? He's feeding the birds. He's feeding the ants. He's feeding the insects. He's feeding the whole creation. And if I'm surrendered to him, will he not feed me? Will he make me star forever? Never possible. So he has this firm faith and belief because he was in love with Vitthal Nath, with Panduranga. Once upon a time, the younger son, he got fever. 105, 106, totally. He was on bed. The wife started shouting at him, Will your Panduranga will take care of this boy? You're not even going out to get medicine for him. And he became least affected by this. And he's just standing, Panduranga, Panduranga. She took the hand of the boy, young boy, and she dragged all the way from her home to the temple, from the street, dragged the boy like this, and came right in front of the deity, Vitthana, Panduranga, and she took her slippers and wants to hit Thakurji, want to hit Panduranga. You spoiled my life. You spoiled my family. Then all the devotees present there stopped. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? With your slippers, you want to hit the Panduranga? So she threw that slipper and threw her boy right in front of the deity, Panduranga, in a very angry mood. She returned back home. Just throw her boy there. And Panduranga, he is smiling. He's standing like this. And he touched the boy with his hand. And boy stood up, healthy, without any fever, no, nothing. And he came running back home. Ma, ma, mother, mother, mother. And she saw, oh. Who made you like this? He said, Panduranga. And she became so envious to Panduranga. She didn't like this. Stupid nonsense. I don't believe this. In this way, she's always opposing her husband. Always opposing her husband. But even though he's staying at home, he was least affected. And he's all the time chanting and chanting and chanting. So there are many pastimes like this. Very touching. So much touching stories of Panduranga, Vitthalnath. Why I'm saying this? Because Vishwaroop Prabhu, after going through all the holy places, when he came to Pandharpur, Vitthalnath, he saw the deity and he entered into the deity. He entered into the deity, Vitthalnath, Vishwaroop Prabhu. And if I'm not wrong, on this day, he entered the deity of Vitthalnath. I'm not 100% sure. So, Shri Nitan Prabhu, considered to be as elder brother of Mahaprabhu. Hagara Nitai, Toraduti Bhai, Adhama Patita Bandhu. In this bhajan, Gaura Nitai, Toraduti Bhai, you are brothers. But brother of Mahaprabhu was Vishwaroop Prabhu. Mother Sachi gave name Vishwaroop to elder brother and Vishwambhar to younger brother, means Mahaprabhu. So Vishwaroop Prabhu, he entered in this, in the body of Shri Vitthalnath. Mahaprabhu entered in the body of Tota Gopinath in Jagannath Puri. When some devotees, when we went to India, we have seen that the only one Krishna deity in the whole world who is sitting and playing flute. Sitting. And when we sit like this, like, you know, in a posture, when we chant mantra, we sit like this. The knee to the thighs, we see, you know, I don't know how to explain this. There's a line, right? When we sit and near our thighs, it comes a line. So that's a golden line on the legs of Shri Gopinath. It's a golden line, not black line. Because Mahaprabhu entered here in the body of Shri Tota Gopinath. So, Shri Nityananda Prabhu, while going through all the places of pilgrimage, when he came to this Vitthalnath, Pandharpur, he remembered this, he understood this. Vishwaroop Prabhu entered in the body of Vitthalnath. So today, on this day, Vishwarup Mahotsav, we heard little what is mentioned in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita about Sri Vishwarup Prabhu. Vishwarup Mahotsav, and that's why we shave on this day because of his disappearance day. We shave on this day. Sachi Mata, she was in tears. She was crying so much. My elder brother Vishwarup, my elder son Vishwarup left me, and there's no whereabouts. Where is he? We don't know anything. Then later, Nimai also wants to, he was also going to Sri Advaita Acharya Prabhu and hearing Bhagavatam from him. Nimai. And seeing this, Sachi Mata also became worried that because of association of Advaita, my elder brother already renounced me. Leave me, and he renounced. He left me and he renounced. Now I'm seeing Nimai also developing the same mood. If he also leaves me and he will renounce, that I'm alone in this world, have no one. That's why Sachi Mata, she was little upset. She had with Acharya Prabhu and she said, you're not Advaita, you are Dvaita. Advaita means one who has no envious, who is not jealous, not envious. But you are Dvaita, you are envious. Because of your association, my sons are leaving me. So why you are envious to us? And this was an offense of Sachi Mata towards Sri Advaita Acharya Prabhu. That happened when Mahaprabhu was young boy. But Mahaprabhu, when he was distributing his prema, the wealth of prema to everyone in the house of Srivas Pandit, after many years, Mahaprabhu still had this in his head, that when I was young, Mother Sachi, she offended Advaita Acharya. Therefore, Mahaprabhu didn't want to give prema to Sri Advaita Acharya Prabhu, to Sachi Mata. He don't want to give prema to Sachi Mata. Why? Mahaprabhu, in his absorption, when he was giving this distributing prema, he said, I will not give to my mother. And everyone was surprised. What's wrong with your mother? She's your mother. She's the mother of the whole universe. But Mahaprabhu said, no, because she offended Advaita Acharya. How can she say Advaita as Dvaita? This shows how much love Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had for Sri Advaita Acharya Prabhu. Because of Advaita, I'm here, he said. Because of his roaring in separation and sad to see the misery of this world, the people of this world, he called upon me. And because of him, I came in this world. And how come, even if it is my mother, I will not give prema to my mother. I will not give prema to my mother. Only if she asks forgiveness from Advaita and take the food dust from his lotus feet, then I can consider her giving prema. All the devotees begged to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, don't do like this. She's mother. But Mahaprabhu is not partial at all. Same, equal to everyone. And through Sachi Mata, Mahaprabhu wants to give this message to everyone. How offensive is Vaishnava Parad? Offense towards Vaishnava. So therefore, many lessons in the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Also, is Sannyas Day of Param Gurudev, Sri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Krishna Goswami Maharaj. Shri Param Gurudev was Brahmachari. When even in his white cloth, what to speak of saffron cloth, white cloth Brahmachari. Shri Param Gurudev, earlier known as Vinod Bihari Brahmachari, he joined Srila Prabhupada in the very early years of the preaching mission of Shri Prabhupada. Almost like 1918, when Prabhupada had just begun preaching. So Param Gurudev and Paramanand Puri, Paramanand Prabhu, they are the ones, the beginners, in the beginning years of Prabhupada preaching, joined Srila Prabhupada. And many other acharyas who got sannyas from Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, they are 18 in number. 18 acharyas got direct sannyas from Srila Prabhupada. And then later on, many others, they took sannyas from their godbrothers. But direct sannyasi disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada, 18. Bhakti Raksha Srila Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Sarvas Giri Goswami Maharaj. You're going to hear this in this book, Beloved Masters. So many of them got direct sannyas. Even though they joined Srila Prabhupada after Param Gurudev. But then why Param Gurudev didn't took direct sannyas from Srila Prabhupada, even though he was senior amongst all? Because of his services. What services? Very difficult ones. Because a sannyasi cannot do those services. Otherwise, it's a bad repute in the society. What Gaudiya Vaishnava sannyasis are doing? Bad reputation. Because Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada, when he developed this preaching, when he started preaching, it was not that easy as we see now. There were many oppositions from scholars, from learned people. They were giving so much attention to each and every word which is coming from the mouth of Srila Prabhupada. How much gravity. And that's why Prabhupada is so selective in using the words and his sentences and his lectures, in his delivering lectures, so selective. Because all in those days, the audience were learned Sanskrit scholars. If there is single mistake, they make a big issue out of it. And because Srila Prabhupada was preaching boldly, the stream of pure dhara, the pure stream of bhakti, and the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sri Rupa Goswami, that's why he was very, very attentive and selective in speaking, and even in his conduct. Right? So, Param Gurudev, why he didn't took sannyas directly from him? Even though he was so senior amongst all, he was wearing white cloth because of his services to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, which was very challenging services that he performed. And that is to save Sri Dham Mayapur, Sri Mayapur Dham, which was controlled by many Muslims staying there. So and so that they have even changed the name Mayapur to Miyapur. Today we just go there without any problem. But that was not the case years back when Prabhupada Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur was present. That was a very challenging time. And that was a desire of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Srila Prabhupada that this place should be reserved as Gaudiya Vaishnava. Preserved as Gaudiya Vaishnavas. The birth of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why when we go there now, what we see? The temples, all in one line. Gaudiya Math. Because the contribution of Param Gurudev, Sri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. So, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami Maharaj used to say, in this preaching movement, there were some acharyas who were in front line and they got acknowledged by people worldwide. But there were some acharyas who were not in front line. They were doing everything from behind the curtain, he used to say. You know, like any drama, any movie, those who are in front line, we only see them and we know them. But can they do anything alone by themselves without the support of those who are in the back of the curtain, or back line? No, the whole teamwork is there. Similarly, we know some acharyas, like, of course, Shishima Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaji, also so much challenges on his path to preach Krishna consciousness, especially in this challenging mood in Western world. People who don't even know anything, no etiquette, no conduct, nothing. It was such a big challenge. But again, see his humility. When his godbrothers glorified him for this achievement and his service to his Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, that, oh, they used to say, oh, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, what you have done, you made impossible possible. You converted Western people to Krishna bhaktas, Krishna consciousness. So difficult, impossible possible. Taking humble position, he used to say, no, that was simple. You see his words. He said, that was simple, but what you, my God brothers, what you preaching here in this country, India, is more challenging what I preach in Western world. Because I am preaching to those who are ignorant, those who don't know anything. I'm just telling them Krishna is Supreme Lord and they're accepting that. I'm just telling follow this rule and regulation, they're accepting that without further inquiries. But preaching in India was not that easy, and also is not that easy now. Because everyone knows religion. Everyone aware of Krishna pastime, Rama pastime, and the etiquette, rule and regulation, everyone is aware of. And nowadays, it's little delusion, little diluted. Not little, so much diluted. But I'm speaking about those years when our acharyas were preaching. Audience was not that easy. They were not ignorant. They're the one who are fully fluent in the Shastras. They knew Srimad Bhagavatam by, you know, heart, everything. So Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaji glorifying God Brother, saying that was more challenging for all of you to preach in India when there were so many other so-called Vaishnavas were so prominent. Like Bhakti Sirup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, whose disappearance coming 8th September. Sri Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj was preaching in Bangladesh, which was also a territory of India. And he openly spoke to that personality who is so famous, even worshipped now in the whole Bengal and in Bangladesh. Vivekananda. So prominent. Everyone, the whole world know about him. And his Gurudev, Ramakrishna Paramahansa. You are going to hear this in this book, Beloved Master, how boldly in the assembly of 1,000 people, he said, that's totally bogus. He spoke like this. And there was so much opposition from the audience. They just, you know, they retaliated. And the whole program for some days, the program was there for some days. All came to an end. But then Srila Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj and Bhakti Raksha Srila Goswami Maharaj requested the magistrate, the judge, to please allow us and we will take care of that. No other statement like this is going to come from our side. How wonderfully they reconciled this. And the audience glorified Gaudiya Vaishnava. But Bhakti Swarup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj, he boldly spoke against those who are against bhakti, the pure bhakti. Because they're saying, their philosophy say, jiva daya, compassion on jivas. So in their definition of jiva, it's not what we understand jiva. For us, jiva means all living entities, including animals, right? Birds, aquatic, even birds, trees and creepers, all living entities. That's why we don't kill them, we don't eat them. But in their sampradaya, they only think jiva is human beings. So therefore they don't preach. I mean, they don't inspire people to give up meat eating. They're eating dog, they're eating fish, they're eating all other animals. Because they're thinking jiva means only human beings. Yeah, there's some philosophical, there are many other reasons. So that was the case. So challenging to preach in India. But that was the humility of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. That was his humble mood. But actually both cases are challenging. But we see only one side. We only see, okay, preaching in Western world was challenge, struggling. But also other side, preaching in India was more struggling and challenging from so much opposition. There is no opposition in Western world, to little opposition to some degree. But in India, more than 90% from every corner, from different sects, from different religions, from different sampradayas, from many people, even audience, etc. Not easy. So Param Gurudev, he preserved Shri Dham Mayapur, Shri Mayapur Dham, only for Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Today when we go there without any problem, it is only because of Shri Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. He used to ride on horse, being a brahmachari, because he was familiar with this. As he was son of rich, very wealthy landlord, he born in a landlord family. The whole village belongs to him, his father. So landlords, they always used to, living very opulent, and they have horse ride and etc. So Param Gurudev was familiar with this. This was not something new for him. He used to ride on horse and going to the fields in Shiddham Mayapur, showing his influence, being a brahmachari, going out of the way to serve the mission of Srila Prabhupada and the dream of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Going out of the way, riding on horse and preserving Mayapur Dham. So that to show his influence, that we Vaishnavas don't think and don't take us very easy. We can also ride on horse, and we are also like Kshatriyas. Okay? We are also ready to fight for our rights, because this is the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. This is the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. So Param Gurudev used to ride on horse like this. And then Srila Gurudev explains, Param Gurudev, when he was crossing the ghat from Mayapur to Navdeep or Navdeep to Mayapur, you have to ride on boat. Boat ride for 15 minutes. Very cheap. Only 10 cents. Even now. If you compare with your euro and dollar, how much is it? 10 cents only. Boat ride. But Param Gurudev, instead of paying 10 cents, he was paying like $2 or $3. Why? There was some purpose behind this. And some devotees came to Srila Prabhupada saying, Vinod Bihari Brahmachari spoiling the money of Gaudiya Math. Instead of paying 10 cents, in those days, maybe like 1 cent, it's 10 cents today. 1 cent, even less than that. And Param Gurudev paying $1. How much difference is that? 100 times more. So complaint came to Srila Prabhupada. He's spoiling money. But Param Gurudev, sorry, Srila Prabhupada smiled to hear this. He knew the mood of Param Gurudev. He cannot do anything wrong. Everything, all his actions appears they are not appropriate, but it's all meant to serve me. It's all meant to serve me. And why Param Gurudev was doing this? Because he wants to show his influence by his power, his strength, riding on horse, and also by money. And that's the reason all these boat men, they were Muslims. And they, when Param Gurudev coming to Ghat, they all coming, running to him, addressing him as Babuji, 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 means, oh sir, please come my boat. Oh sir, please come my boat. And Param Gurudev used to show his influence. And that was the cause, the reason he dragged those Muslims out from Sri Dham Mayapur. Otherwise, it was so difficult. Yeah. Acharyas behind the scene. How many of us? Okay, we understand the glories of Param Gurudev. I'm speaking about the worldwide Vaishnav congregation. How many of them, they understand this gravity of Param Gurudev's contribution preserving Sri Dham Mayapur? Only handful. Because it's our Param Gurudev, we know this. But many others, they don't know this. Because unhidden. Oh, sorry, hidden. Behind the scenes, preserving Sri Dham Mayapur. Then my Guru Maharaj and others who did publication work, who know them, very few people know them. Very few Vaishnavas know their contribution. How today we're reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, we're reading Bhagavatam, we're reading other books of Bhakti Thakur, but who worked on that and made it available for all of us in Bengali language, then further translated to English and Hindi, etc. Who was day and night, hours and hours. Today, when I heard some of the devotees, they didn't sleep for 30, 40 hours and worked on this book. I was remembering how Guru Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj also, he used to sleep 2 or 3 hours a day. That's all. Not for 1 or 2 days. But for years and years and years. And that's why you see my Guru Maharaj, not because of old age. You see my pictures of my Guru Maharaj, he's like, he's hunched like this. It's not because of old age, but because whole life he was working on those books throughout his life. No computers, nothing, just writing and editing and manual printing press, not computerized mechanical printing press. Manual, everything manual. So not 1 or 2 days, but years and years and years. They gave up their life, blood and sweat, everything. That's called surrenderness. Are we ready for this? Can we do this? Yes, we can. We can. According to whatever qualification we have, we can also serve the mission of Mahaprabhu like this. Without any expectation of reward. Without any acknowledgement. Selfless service. But who's going to acknowledge this? This is verse says, Kirtane Parishram Jane Gaurarai. Gaurarai means Mahaprabhu. He knows, he acknowledges the Parishram. Parishram means the endeavor one put in performing Kirtan. Here, the word Kirtan is not restricted only to singing or to speaking Harikatha. Of course, that is there. But here, Kirtan means all the services which is meant, all services which is there to serve the mission of Mahaprabhu. There's the mission of Mahaprabhu, there's the mission of Rupa Goswami, there's the mission of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, there's the mission of Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, all acharyas and our Gurudev. Same mission. Jive Daya Name Ruchi. Vaishnav Seva. That's the essence. Jive Daya, compassion of Jivas. Name Ruchi. Taste in chanting Harinam. And then Vaishnav Seva. Three aligned. Not giving up chanting. Oh, for the compassion of the Jivas, I'm working day and night, but I'm not chanting. No, that's not proper. Compassion on Jivas, taste in chanting, and then Vaishnav Seva. Are we ready to sacrifice our time, our day and night? Can we burn our blood like this? One who does this, later they realize this. Yes, they feel they acknowledge something. They got something. Because Mahaprabhu is acknowledging this. I just don't want to tell this or share this, but some little... When Srila Gurudev gave us this service of publication, we spent so many weeks and months and years like this. Almost 10 years in publication. So many years. And nobody even knew us that we are with Srila Gurudev. Nobody knew us. We never used to go parikrama. We never used to go any occasion. Just sitting in a room, working. I'm just not saying to show off. Please don't take it otherwise. Well, not because of that I'm saying. But there was, when I heard the devotees telling that they worked so hard for some days on this book, I remembered my days. When Srila Gurudev was present, so many nights spending in the printing press without sleeping, without food. Where to get food there? Vegetarian food. There was nothing to eat some days. No sleeping bed. Sitting with the employees in the printing press, sitting with them and just, you know, on the chair, little nap, and then start work again. Anyway, don't want to mention that. But how Param Gurudev, he worked so hard to preserve Shida Mayapur. And that's the reason some devotees ask Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Srila Saraswati Thakur, why Vinod Bihari Brahmachari not taking sannyas, even though he's qualified? But some devotees said, no, he should not. Because then who's going to take care of this kind of service? A sannyasi cannot ride on horse. A sannyasi cannot, you know, wear those clothes. But Prabhupada, he went out of the way to serve Shida Mayapur and many other services. This is only one I'm focusing on. But when Srila Prabhupada left this world, later years, Sri Param Gurudev, on this day, he got sannyas from Sri Srimad Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. He got sannyas from him. But Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada came in a dream of Param Gurudev and already gave him sannyas prior to that. And similarly, it happened with my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj took sannyas from Bhakti Gaurav Vaikhanas Maharaj. Many of you not even heard those names. But when you read this book, my beloved master, then we understand the glories of these acharyas, how glorious they were. So my Guru Maharaj, he took sannyas from him after Srila Prabhupada. that was a time when many of our Guru Vargas didn't took direct sannyas from Prabhupada because of their busy schedule and their services, which were like that. But many of them got sannyas mantra and dream from Srila Prabhupada, like my Guru Maharaj. Prabhupada came in his dream and gave him sannyas. And then later on, he got sannyas from one of his godbrothers. So today on this sannyas day, sannyas day of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, he took sannyas from Param Gurudev, Shishman Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. So today is a very special day. All glories to this Acharyas of Bhakti Siddhanta Sakti Thakur Prabhupada. No matter how much we hear the glories from Bhagavatam, Krishna pastime, Mahaprabhu pastime, Chaitanya Charitamrita, but I'm telling you, from my heart, if we don't hear the glories of disciples of Bhakti Siddhanta Sakti Thakur Prabhupada, we cannot advance. We cannot become firm and fixed in following the rules and regulations. So many details, so much minute details. So many details present in them. And that's why Sri Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Gosai Maharaj, he opened his heart and gave those details to us. Such a great gift. When we read this, we hear this, then you will understand. Such a real gift he gave to us. Hare Krishna. Gaur Pivanande Hari Hari Bol. Jai Param Gurudev, Shri Shriman Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj ki jai. His sannyas de ki jai. Shri Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj ki jai. His sannyas de ki jai. And Shri Vishwarup Prabhu ki jai. Sapasha Sajindan Gaurhari ki jai, Shri Purnima ki jai, and the beginning of the third month of Chaturmasya ki jai. Not drinking milk this month. Fasting from milk starts today. Hare Krishna. But you can have yogurt now.